Welcome back to the Friday Matinee on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHTS. George Cummings here, flying solo for one more week. T-Cats is out on adventures involving London and New York and, you know, just having a great old time. She'll be back next week, though. I call her my professional better half. But we are here today and very, very, very excited to have in the studio someone who is actually a Santa Clarita native but has gone on to do good things around the world, Chris DeRubis.
Thank you for having me.
And you just go by DeRubis, though, usually, right?
Yeah, usually, yeah.
That's good. I'm going to push the microphone just a little bit closer.
Hang on, this is live. Go ahead. That was a little bit closer.
Is that
awesome.
Is that better?
Is great.
All right.
Awesome. That keeps things moving. Now, the sake of art, I always like to say, and I read this somewhere, but I've stolen this, is that it's to provoke and not to pander. And by provoke, I mean not like starting a fight, but provoke thought, provoke inspiration, and provoke a kind of something that takes you out of your own skin, even if it's just for a brief period. Now, your work that you developed, the idea of abstract sensualism, and you use a lot of different means to make this happen. You're not just a pencil and canvas kind of guy.
No.
You work in metals. You work in all kinds of different components there. And tell me a little bit about what abstract sensualism is.
Well, like you were mentioning, provoke emotion. That's really what it comes down to. My goal is to have someone blown away, something memorable, something emotional. The satisfaction I get from people looking at my artwork is the emotional attachment when someone cries or someone just blows their mind. They can't believe like how beautiful it is, or the story that it reminds them of when they buy something. Like just last week in Maui, a young brother and sister came in their early 20s, and both their parents passed away, but they were like basically inseparable. And I had this two turtle painting where they're in the water, and it reminded them of their parents. They never left each other's side. They're always, you can never split them up. They were, you know, side by side. And so it was a lot of emotion for them going on. And for me, that was kind of a special moment to see that someone, you know, my paintings brings things into their home, into their life of memories that they had, you know, as they were a child. You know, it's pretty cool.
And in a way that a lot of people who may not initially understand art the way other people do, it depends on their level of expectation and whether or not how their exposure to it as well. That's something that we don't always think about is the emotion that it draws, even if it's something abstract or something that like in your case, you do a lot of panels and you do a lot, work with a lot of metals and different types of things. Like I said, it's not just a canvas on paint, right?
Yeah, it's a painting and it's kind of like a sculpture, because what the painting does is it floats off the wall without a frame. Some of them are single panels, but a lot of them are multi-panels and they're abstract pieces. And so no two pieces can be exactly alike. It's impossible. So the only drawback for me in my sense is I have to work all the time, because there is no print. They're all originals, one of one. And the good thing about it is that it's special. Each person has the only one in the world, and so they cannot be duplicated. So it's kind of special to them.
Right. Now you have, hello. Hi, how are you? It's all good. This is live radio. But talking about your artwork and abstract, how did you even come up with that concept?
I was playing around with stuff in my parents' garage. I mean, I was an airbrush artist. I worked at Magic Mountain here in town as a kid, doing airbrushing T-shirts.
So you didn't have to like launch people in roller coasters or work the snack bar. You got to do
right away. I was as an artist making money at basically before 16. I got brought in at 15 and a half. They saw the talent. They were training me on how to do what they were doing there. And then right basically when I turned 16, I was able to start making money at it right away. And I did a few things early on with doing that and opening up my own business, doing a T-shirt event party business where I was working with party planners down in Beverly Hills in Los Angeles and doing things with them. And then that grew, and that still is actually going on, and I gave that to somebody else, passed it down to them to run for me. And then, from there I just started working on motorcycles, and that's really where I think it kind of started to turn around from canvas to metal. I started working and messing around with paints that apply to metal, and then the interest of changing from canvas over to the metal was interesting, and I started using power tools and chemicals and destroyed my parents' garage pretty much. I mean, it was a mess. There was stuff everywhere in there.
Well, that's pretty amazing. And again, you are from Santa Clarita. You were like every other teenager who grew up in Santa Clarita. You worked at Magic Mountain, but at least you got to do something kind of more along the lines of of your craft. So pretty much now in looking at your bio, it seems like you have pretty much always had either something in your hand that made you creative, whether it's a crayon or a pencil. And you had some inspiration also from your grandfather, correct?
Very much so, yeah.
And so he's the one that actually inspired and motivated you to continue on and helped you with classes and to learn your craft, right?
Yes. I mean, yes. It was very, with him, he saw it in me at an early age, and he wanted to always become an artist. But his parents that I never had a chance to meet were, you know, they didn't feel comfortable with that. They didn't feel it was a safe direction for him to go, and he regretted not following his dream. So he was basically living his dream through me, and we had so much fun together on the weekends, just coloring and drawing. And he really was, you know, not really pushing me, but just totally supporting me. And he saw it in me, and I really enjoyed it as well. So those things kind of got me going at a very young age.
Well, that's, and your parents too. They also supported you in your efforts, and I think that's really important for any young people to have that. In other words, no negative impressions.
It should be a huge advantage.
And I know that whole thing of, oh, well, yeah, but what do you really want to do in life? And so that's really good that you've had that background to be able to move forward. And so in that, though, and I want to talk when we come back from the break, we have about a minute left before we got to go to this whole commercial thing. But I want to talk about you moving forward, because it wasn't just an easy A to Z quick trip or A to B quick trip from there and being a kid and starting on down this path of abstract essentialism to actually where you have become as renowned as you have.
Yes.
And where you are in in Weiland Galleries, for example, and anybody who has been to Hawaii or is an art aficionado knows who Weiland is, who is another incredibly well-known, world-renowned artist. So to be in his galleries is saying something, right?
Absolutely.
And also cruise ships and things like that. You've been working with Princess Cruises as well, and they're mm-hmm. located out here in Santa Clarita. And you're just home for a very brief time before you're off to do more.
Key West, yeah.
And also, I want to mention your website, too. It's DerubisFineArt.com, and that is spelled D as in Derubis, E-R-U-B as in boy, E-I-S, FineArt.com. And it's got a lot of your information. Talks also, there's a really great video called Behind the Artist that really kind of delves into your motivations and some of your struggles that you've done. And we're going to talk a little bit about that coming back from the break. This is the Friday matinee on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHTS, with our guest, Derubis, fine artist. We'll be right back after this. Sing us in, Frankie. And we're back with the Friday matinee on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHTS. It is my honor to have Derubis in studio with me, a fine artist and originator of abstract sensualism, which we had discussed in our previous segment. Also talked a little bit about the motivations behind, a little bit about your life, how you got started. And you were a typical teen, Santa Clarita, who worked at Magic Mountain, but at least got to do airbrushing and things, and again, didn't have to schlep popcorn or mm-hmm. you know,
went walk. Went to Canyon High School.
Canyon High School.
Graduated in 96. Yeah.
Wow, okay. So I know some kids that you probably went to school with. I'd have to remember their names and throw them down, but Canyon High. All right. So you grew up out here, which is really awesome, but you travel around quite a bit and do a lot of bit of traveling. And like you said, you put in a lot of hours in your art because there are no prints, mm-hmm. you know, and everything is original because it's on metal and using different types of chemicals and stuff. So anybody purchasing your art has an original.
Yes.
And that's very important. And it's not only for the investment value, but also for the beauty and art and the aestheticism that art lends to any location. Mm-hmm. But talking about this, though, because it sounds like, you know what, man, I came up with this and I instantly got rich and it was awesome and life went so good. And it really wasn't like that. There was a lot of bumpy roads along the way, right?
Absolutely, yeah. It's never easy, especially when you're just doing it by yourself and you know, all you have is just the support of everybody. That's great. But, you know, you're raising the money yourself to do it and move forward with what you want to do to reach the ultimate goal. And it's definitely not easy to do.
Right. And I know that in looking at some of your background and your information, I mean, you have your whole family behind you and investing even like their own money behind you. But even still, it got really close to the breaking point, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my wife was working two jobs. I was just continuing painting motorcycles and doing whatever art I could. I mean, so I was just constantly working with that. And So we would work as much as we could to save up enough money to put it back onto the credit card so that I can use a credit card again to do another show, because a lot of these expos that I was going to and traveling to in New York and Las Vegas are very expensive. Just even shipping the art there in big crates was expensive, and then to rent the booth and then to get the airplane tickets and then the hotels, and especially, you know, Manhattan it's expensive just to stay there. It's one of the most expensive cities in the world, so it was a real struggle in the beginning to get things really going. It was frustrating, yeah.
But it finally started breaking through. People started catching on, and that was one thing led to another. And mm-hmm. I know you've also been on television, and as you said, you've done many radio interviews
yes.
over the years. And moving forward, though, it's pretty fascinating. You're right about that. And the thing, too, with like a business like yours, because you still have to, even though you're an artist, it's still a business. It's not like you can easily go to the SBA and go, hey, I want a loan. You know, I have this really cool concept. It's called abstract centralism. And so I need X amount of dollars. You know, it's probably not the easiest thing in the world to put that together, to have people who maybe don't understand mm-hmm. the profit loss margin of that. And so you really have to strike out on your own. There is a huge risk, but also when it's done correctly and you get it going, it's a huge payoff. Not only, I mean, I'm not just talking about financially, but even from you know, feeding your soul as an artist, right?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. It's a real humbling experience when you do it yourself, too. It's it makes you not really, I guess, turn into a brat or being arrogant, you know, like, you know, so much when you do it yourself and you have your family behind you supporting you, and it's not just handed to you. I think you cherish it more once you get to that goal. I think it's something a little bit more special. So that part of it also makes it a little bit sweeter, you know.
And in the case of actually, like, what went through your mind? What did you feel like the first time someone purchased your artwork, and not just talking about the motorcycle stuff, but when it actually was all this stuff you've been working all this time?
And you know what? It was exciting, but then it wasn't because do you really want to let those first pieces go? Those are your babies, you know. It's so it was like one of those catch 22 things. It's like tear you apart, but it's exciting at the same time. But then you over time you learn to let those pieces go, even the ones you really fall in love with. You start to understand that, you know, someone is enjoying it just as much as you are, and they're willing to pay for it, and it's time to, you know, let it go.
Right, and it goes, though, beyond just getting a paycheck out of this. It really is that aspect of the validation of what you put your heart and soul into for years and years and years, mm-hmm. and struggled over the years, and finally have been able to do, okay, what I thought of, what was inside my mind, what I thought would be, is that people mm-hmm. actually get it now. I think that's a really important thing with almost any art form, that you're putting it your heart and soul out there in front yeah. of people, right? So talking about that, though, you have your artwork, as you said, in galleries, not only in Wyland Galleries, but in your own places as well, right?
Yeah, five. I have five of my own personal signature locations.
Well, where are these at?
One in Las Vegas at the Venetian Hotel. I have Maui, which I was just in, down in Front Street in Lahaina.
Whoa.
I have San Juan, Puerto Rico, Key West, Florida, which I'll be next week for a big show down in Key West, Florida, and Scottsdale, Arizona.
I always say, if you're going to do something like that, make sure that they are in places that are really, really, really fun to travel to.
Nice, warm places.
Yeah, warm places. Scottsdale is incredible. Even though it's Arizona, it's still an incredible place to go. Mm-hmm. But yeah, Key West, you poor guy. But getting there was really half the struggle, right?
Most definitely.
So with that, though, what do you got coming up?
Well, I have that show coming up in Key West next week. I'll be there for 4 days, next Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And then I travel home for 2 weeks and paint as much as I possibly can. And then I have that Royal Princess Cruise Connoisseur VIP cruise that I'll be going on through the 17th. It starts the 17th of November. It goes out of the Caribbean, so I'll be in another warm climate. And it goes for that week till, I think, the 2017th to the 24th. And so that's a special moment for me, just because of the fact that it's a connoisseur cruise. They invite collectors to come on and purchase my art, and I get a chance to hang out with them, and that's part of the whole fun part, is hanging out, you know, having some wine with them and having dinners and getting to know me getting to know them, and really know where the art's going, you know, what home, who's buying it, so that I can tell their story, you know, to other people. And it'll be the first time I see this new beautiful ship.
Well, that's great. Yeah,
they decorated it with my art, too. There's 17 pieces on board. And there's like a thing that talks about each piece, and so I'm excited to see how it all came together on board the new Royal Princess.
And so, and so you're not that old. You graduated high school in 1996, so to be able
35.
That's not bad. We are going to talk more with DeRubis after our break. I know it goes by so fast, and we're gonna wrap it up and talk more and just do some finishing up right after this. This is the Friday Matinee on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHTS. I'm We're back on the Friday Matinee on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHTS, with world-renowned artist and Santa Clarita resident, Derubis. Welcome back on our final segment. And I will tell you, I am the lucky recipient of one of your business cards, and it is fantastic. I will definitely cherish it. It's a work of art in itself. We're talking about, you know, you're a Santa Clarita resident, but you do travel a lot. And talking also, your wife, you mentioned in a couple segments earlier that she had to work two jobs, at least in the beginning, but now she has kind of a full-time position as a mother of both of your children, and also kind of helping keep that left brain aspect of the art world in check as far as everything else that we don't always like to think about while we're working on.
Absolutely.
And that's pretty terrific. So shout out. What's your wife's name?
Donnell.
Donnell, shout out to you for all the awesome work you've done. Keep up the good work. and you too. And so we're talking about you're got a couple things going. You're going to Key West, right? Coming
yes.
up? Oh, you poor thing. Yeah, no, and you see, I know from the radio, it's probably tough to tell how tan you are. So obviously you're not having any events soon in like Missoula, Montana or St. Paul, Minnesota. but it's nice to have those warm climates and also places where, to be honest, tourists do go. And a lot of times they buy art when they're out there. But it's not just a tourist destination. It's also in areas that are really prone to really good art and that sort of thing. And we're talking about abstract centralism, and you can check out Derubis' website. It's derubisfineart.com. Let me spell that for you. D-E-R-U-B-E-I-S. D as in David, B as in boy. derubisfineart.com. You can check everything out. You find out when your upcoming events are. You can actually even sign up to find out how to meet you in person and when and where you are. And also pictures of your artwork and talking about other things and how you actually get your hands on one, put it up in your own home or office, wherever you choose. And in talking about this, seeing some of these artworks now, also it looks like you do commissions on occasion. Do you still do that?
Kind of. I've tried to slow down on those because it is a bit overwhelming with all just the demand of all the galleries when they sell something to replace fulfill orders. So I do occasionally, depending on the situation and what it is that they're asking for.
And also, though, it does show some of your auto art and things like that as well that you've done. Do you still dabble in that at all?
Or I haven't done that in years now. It's been at least probably 5 years. I haven't touched it with the automotive in a while.
Again, you're traveling a lot. And in between there, of course, you're probably going to go home and do some work, right?
Go home and cook. I enjoy cooking and hanging out, just jump in the pool. You know, when I'm not painting, I spend the time as much as I can just enjoying the family and relaxing, and that's pretty much it.
And that's perfect.
Hit up the golf course.
And again, you're in your mid-30s, you've managed to make it, and that is incredible. So aside from that, your website talks about and discusses abstract centralism. There is a really, really good documentary video, actually kind of goes through your beginnings and a lot of what we talked about, actually, but in some depth there that you can see, as well as Chris's artwork and where your Derubis artwork, and where you also all of your different locations and where you can see the art. It was really cool. On the final note, is there anything, let's say if you have young people that want to get into the art world the way you do or did it, is there anything you would recommend or not recommend if they're going down that path?
I recommend just working as hard as you possibly can. I mean, you know, the time that you put into it's going to show at the end, the end result. If you're not super serious about it, it may be a big struggle for you, but if you put your heart into it and you're really devoted your time and dedicated to it, you know, like a normal job, like 8 hours plus a day, I think that would be the best advice I can give is to do that. And then don't get frustrated and if the results don't happen right away. It's just like a diet. I mean, you want to lose 50 pounds and you start working out, running, like, say, the first week. You're not going to lose all the weight in the first week. It's a journey. It's a mission. It's going to take time. So don't get frustrated if you don't have the results right away. Keep your head up and your spirits high, and I think just keep moving forward because dreams can come true if you really focus and put your heart into it.
I think it's really important for any type of art form that you do treat it as your life, and because it's not just the rock and roll fantasy that somehow someone's going to discover you. You still have to be that salesperson and that again, that left brain side of that job that maybe you don't really like to do and you're not that comfortable. You got to play a little bit of that game to get there too. So that's really important. This has been fascinating and a really enlightening half hour. Really honored to have met you and also get to keep your business card. That's even cooler. That is just cool. I like want to mount that on the wall myself. Look, I have a DeRubis. It's a business card. But it's like abstract centralism in itself, you know. So thanks so much for coming out. Again, that website is DeRubisFineArt.com, DeRubis. fineart.com, and also have a link to that on our website as well, or our Facebook page as well. It's KHTS AM, facebook.com/KHTSAM. Thanks so much for coming out. You're really welcome. Appreciate it, and enjoy the rest of your day, and good luck on your tours and everything else you got coming up.
Thank you very
All
much.
All right. This has been the Friday Matinee on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHTS. I'm George Cummings. Stay tuned for the Gazette Radio Hour coming up after this.